Hello everyone, it is January 15th, 2017. It has been quite cold this week. We've had quite a bit of snow, so it's been a lot of cleanup and just kind of staying warm, but we're finally getting a little bit warmer weather, so I'm back out in the shop and I'm gonna start on the next project. So in front of me here, I got a box. It says Sterrett, Athol, Massachusetts, United States of America. So, you know, Sterrett, gotta be something nice in the box. And inside, a Sterrett number 255 flush reading vernier height gauge. So, number 255, there it is. The 255 is a 14 and a half inch, there it is, number 255, is a 14 and a half inch vernier height gauge. Still has all the muck on it from the last time it was calibrated. I don't know when that was. I also have its, we'll call it its fraternal twin sister, the Sterrett number 255M, there it is there. So the 255, like I said, is 14 and a half inches. The 255M is metric and 350 millimeters. So for all intents and purposes, these two are identical. And the 255 that I have does have a nice box. I still have some of the pieces for it. The 255M, however, I don't have a case for it. Its little extension here just sits on it, and the height gauge just kind of sits on the shelf out of the way. So I thought it might be time to make myself a box for, let's just get these things out of the way here, for the 255M. So I went and got myself some wood from the lumber yard, and I got some half inch by 5.5 inch by 36 inch oak, as well as some 3 millimeter plywood to make a box. So my thought was pretty much just make a duplicate of the box for the 255. And that way we'll be able to protect the height gauge. So let's get started. All right, so the existing box is 18 inches wide by 7¾ inches wide by 3 inches high. Just draw that out here. So what did we say? 18 inches by 7¾ by 3 inches. All right, so my wood here has some tear out on the end, so I'm just gonna cut both of these pieces at the same time here, so I have a nice square edge on the end of the board. Nice and clean. All right, so the first cut I'll make here is at 18 inches. Thank you. All right, and then the next cut we'll make is the 7¾-inch end pieces. The existing box is 1¼ inches deep, so times two for the top. So the inside of the box needs to be 2½ inches. I was going to inlay, or not inlay, but recess the 3mm plywood. I was going to cut grooves in the oak and recess the 3mm plywood. So what I'll do is I will cut roughly about 1/4 inch on the in and 1/4 inch, or 1/4 inch on the top, 1/4 inch on the bottom. So if I made my overall thickness 3 inches, that should give me room for the gauge inside. The 7¾-inch end pieces I will cut at my miter saw. The longer 18-inch pieces, my miter saw doesn't have enough range to cut that, so we'll do that on the table saw. Now, here's a little trick for you. So I'm going to cut both of these pieces of wood at the same time, so that each piece is exactly the same. So I put my clamp in my miter saw, but obviously it's not long enough to get over to the edge. What you can do is, I have some of the cut-off scraps from the end, so you can make a hold-down clamp. I'll set two of them over on the end, and then I can put another piece of wood between the two. And then I've got my clamp that I'm able to clamp down on and hold both pieces of wood. There it is, clamped down. It is square to the back of the fence and right where we need to cut. So let's get this thing cut. Well, there is our nice 3-inch by 7¾-inch end pieces for the box. I've got my table saw out, and I'm going to cut the 18-inch pieces of wood on the table saw, because my miter saw can't quite cut the entire piece at once. So to get the 18-inch pieces exactly as wide as the end pieces of the box, I'm going to use these as the template between the fence and the blade to get the cut exactly the same. So all we do is just lay it in there, set it against the blade, push your fence against it. You don't need to push very hard, because you don't want to flex the blade at all. You just need to push it up again so that it's flush, and then lock your fence down, and now you are ready to make that cut. And there we go. Nice clean cut. I've got my square set up so that, if you can see there, it's set to 1.5 inches so that I can mark the center center of the board. And I'm just going to use one as a template to set up my table saw to cut the slots for the plywood. Now I want 2.5 inches inside the box to accommodate the foot or the base of the height gauge. So I want to make a cut that's 1.25 inches away from center on either side of the line. So I will just set my ruler up just like that, and that'll be 1.25. It's right there, and 1.25 right here. And then I'll make a 3 millimeter wide, so it'll be a blade in a little bit, width here and here to be able to set the birch plywood in. Before we head over to the table saw, I want to cut the slots on the top and the bottom of the box 3/16 of an inch deep. So I thought I would use this opportunity to show you guys how to measure a veneer height gauge. This will also work for veneer calipers and veneer micrometers. So just for a test, I took the extension off of the 255M, and I know that this is 10 millimeters thick. So we'll set that underneath the height gauge, push it down, lock it down, and then we tip it up here. So on your veneer gauge, on this particular one, there's two measurements. We've got the right hand side here, which is the coarse measurement, and that measures in 1/10 of an inch. So we've got 0.05 inches, 0.1 inch, 0.15, 0.2, 0.25, all the way up to 1 inch. And then on the left hand side, this gauge measures up to 50/1000 of an inch. So that would be 0.05, 0.045, 0.04, and so on. So when making your measurement, the first number that you want to write down is the coarse measurement. And so you take where the zero falls on your coarse measurement gauge. So in this case, it falls between 0.35 and 0.4 inches. So the first number we're going to write down is 0.35 inches. The next thing you want to do is on the left side of the gauge, you want to go up to where the lines match up. So you look up here, see they're not matching, starting to get close. At 0.40 thousandths, it's close, 41, 42. I'm going to say 43 thousandths is right where it matches up. So then the next number you want to write down is 0.043. 0.043, and then where we've written the number down, so I've got 0.35 plus 0.43 is 3930, and I know that there's 25.4 millimeters per inch, so 10 divided by 25.4. So I already done the math on that. That's 0.393 inches. So I'll use this gauge. So that's how, that's how you measure with a vernier caliper. And so I'll use this gauge to set up 3/16 of an inch depth, and I'll get the table saw set up. All right, the table saw is set up. So let's make our cuts.
And there we go. We got slots cut at the tops and bottoms of the box. And let's just check the fit here. Oh man, those fit nice. So that will be absolutely perfect for the box. So let's get this thing glued up.
All right, there it is. It's all clamped together. So we'll let the glue set. And then we'll cut this thing in half and we'll have a box. All right, the box is set enough that we can handle it. It's been about 3 hours, so I got the strap off. So now what we can do is measure the center of the box here, and then we'll put it on the table saw and cut it in half. All right, off to the table saw. All right, the saw is set up. So here goes nothing. Let's look inside this thing. There we go. Not too bad. We get the sander and the scraper out and we can clean some of this stuff out of here, but I am very pleased with how that turned out. On second thought, I've decided that I will put the hinges on first. And then once it's done and square, I can take it apart and clean it up. So I will just duplicate what's on the other box. Just get my square and measure to the center of the existing hinges from the edge. Lock that down. And then I know on the existing box, the center of the hinges, go right there, bring it down, sorry for the heater, and then right there.
There it is. Hinges nicely. So I'm quite happy with that. I've got the gauge just resting inside there, and the box closes very nicely. It's not hitting on the inside. So now what I can do is start making the supports to hold the gauge on the inside of the box. What I did notice is the pieces of oak that I have left over, when stacked too high, they're the same height as the support for the gauge. So what I'll do is I'll use these old pieces of oak here, not old pieces, but the leftover pieces of oak, and we'll make the supports for the gauge. The back support is mounted in there and it fits perfectly. So I've got another few blocks right here, too high. I'll put a couple on the side here. I'll glue them together, clamp them, and then glue that to the base of the box. All right, here we go. Clamp down and we'll let that set, and then we will put it at the bottom of the box. All right, the support is dried enough that we can set it in the box and clamp it down and just set it in there. Mark exactly on the bottom where it needs to go. Take that out. All right, we'll let that dry and we'll start cleaning the box up. It's the next morning and the glue has dried on the supports for the gauge. I also put in the hold down so when the box is closed, it doesn't tip out and move around in the box, but it's actually really nice. There's not much play in the box, so it'll keep the gauge secured. So I've got my palm sander and I will start cleaning up. There's a little bit of burn from cutting through with the table saw in various places. So I will
like up on here on the top. I will get the palm sander out and I'll start cleaning that up, and then we will put something on it to protect the box. I decided to go a little bit different. I decided I'm not gonna put a finish on the box. I did get the palm sander out and I sanded the box smooth and just put a little round over on each corner so it wasn't so sharp. The box, I'm very happy with it. The height gauge is held pretty snugly inside there. And then when I close the top, the height gauge, you can just listen, doesn't really rattle around that much in there. So the box will protect the height gauge while it's sitting on the shelf so that I can use it in the future. A couple of things that I would do differently with the box. I bought these brass hardware from the hardware store. The hinges didn't turn out that badly. I was able to drill the hole and mount the hinges and everything went okay. The only thing I'm disappointed in was the latches. They came with these little brass screws that were weak at best. I don't know if you can see this here on the phone, but most of them sheared off. Even after pre-drilling a hole, the oak was just so hard that it sheared them off. So I went into the nut and bolt bin and found some new screws. The unfortunate part of that is with the screw sheared off in the wood, I just moved the screw over. So none of the screws actually lined up. I'm a little bit disappointed in that, but doesn't impact the functionality of the latch. Additionally, these little loops, I would not use those again. I would just put a single screw on the bottom for the latch to loop around. But for the first box I've made, live and learn, I guess. So other than that, I'm happy with how the box turned out. It will serve its purpose to protect the gauge. So that's gonna conclude this video. If you like the video, please hit the like button. Please provide any comments for future videos, future projects, and please subscribe. So we'll see you on the next project. Have a good one.